Hey, welcome to a new video about an out-of-the-norm manufacturing technique, which has surprising results. It's explosion forming.
This is Design Education with Mia Tahan.
Explosion forming, or high-energy forming, is a manufacturing process which applies to sheet metal and metal tubes. Its first use dates back to 1888, and then it became more frequent to use it during and following the two world wars. An example of the results you get is this image. This was done by a Dutch company for a facade of a building. As you can see, the results are very detailed and the scale is quite big. Let's talk about how we go from explosion to beautifully detailed sheet metal. Today, there are two types of explosion processes. Both are done in a contained environment, like a tank or some kind of container. So the first technique is to have the sheet metal near the explosion and put them both in either water, oil, or open air. The second technique is to place the explosion right next to the sheet metal. So the sheet metal is placed on a mold, and the explosion will cause the sheet metal to take the shape of the mold. So this can be a cost-effective method if the pieces are complex. The speed of production varies from each project, so if you have loads of small pieces to make that would require one explosion, each explosion takes an hour to prepare. So if you had a bunch of small pieces, then that would take you maybe a couple of hours. But if you had to make the facade of a building, like the first example that we saw, then you would need probably several days. The surface quality of the pieces is really, really high, so you don't really need to polish or need to do any kind of work after the explosion. Usually these pieces are treated beforehand, so they are pre-painted, and they're coated in a protective layer. This process was developed because, honestly, why not? This kind of shows that engineers can go outside of the box and create techniques and ways of treating materials that are completely, like, seem crazy. We can't talk about the pros and the cons because this is really, like, this is actually a real process. And it's not just to say, like, oh, we can make things with explosions. It's actually, like, a process that's used in many fields. We can talk about the pros and the cons. So the pros are that it is highly precise. The cost is reasonable compared to similar processes, and you can make complex shapes which eliminate manufacturing steps like soldering. The cons are that it's not widely available, which means that not a lot of manufacturers will have the equipment or the space to do this kind of process. And the other con is that you need to follow very strict security rules because you really want the explosion to be contained and you don't want to have any errors with that. This process is actually used in many fields, so it's mostly used in architectural structures, building facades, as we said. It's used in the aerospace and automobile industries, and during the two world wars, it was used to make missile heads. Now let's talk about the environmental impact of this process. So this process needs a lot of energy, which means that it's going to emit a lot of CO2. The other point is also that you need toxic chemicals to trigger this explosion, so that's also not great for the environment. It's not the most eco-friendly way of treating sheet metal. So there are similar methods that we can use for sheet metal forming. There's stamp forming, which is great. There's superplastic aluminum forming, and there's metal blowing. So that's it. That's the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. I hope that you learned something new. Please let me know in the comments what you thought, and subscribe for more every week. See you later!